Hello everyone, today we will be exploring the dominant player bug. Pay attention to the order Trade Prince Galawix and Gadgets and Auctioneer are played in, then try and predict which one will trigger first. Something is clearly wrong here. Both of these minions trigger on the same event whenever a spell is cast, yet they trigger it in opposite order play. If you're not convinced, let's watch the exact same setup again, with Trade Prince Galawix played first, again, and Gadgetzan Auctioneer played second, again. Watch us with the exact same setup, Trade Prince Galawix now triggers first. To explain what is going on, we have to go over some terminology first. Let's define an event. Events are changes in the game state and specific phases of sequences. Events include damage, healing, death, and the end of turn phase. Let's define a trigger. Triggers listen for a specific event, and whenever it occurs, queue and resolve one by one for it. Triggers include triggered effects or lightning bolts, secrets, and death rattles. These definitions may sound a bit tautological, but we classify things as events or triggers based on common properties they all share. Let's define a queue. Each event gets its own queue to hold triggers. In particular, in a group of simultaneous events, all the damage or deaths or whatever occur, then we resolve consequences of each event one by one in order play, oldest to newest. When we start resolving an event, the queue is populated with all triggers that are eligible and in play, again using order play, oldest to newest. Then it is closed to new entries. Here is an example of how queues work. Both Deathlords are killed simultaneously, and each one puts a flesh-eating ghoul into play. Each death event separately queues and resolves all triggers that exist at the start of the death event being resolved, meaning the first ghoul put into play triggers on the second, but the second ghoul put into play triggers on neither. Now we can define the dominant player bug as follows. When triggers from both players queue on the same event, the dominant player's triggers go first, regardless of order of play. This subtle bug affects everything in Hearthstone. The dominant player bug has been observed for every kind of trigger that we've tested. Here we can see it with on-heal triggers. First, Kalinko plays a cleric, then I play a cleric, then Kalinko plays a second cleric and heals. First, Kalinko's clerics trigger in order of play, then mine triggers last, despite being second in order of play. Here is another example with end of turn phase triggers. First, Xinhuan plays Master Swordsmith and Emperor Farisan, then I play Kel'Thuzad, then Xinhuan plays Gruul. When Xinhuan ends his turn, all his end of turn triggers queue and resolve in order of play, then mine triggers last, again defying order of play. So, which player is the dominant player? It's not related to who went first or who gets the coin, but to an internal tag called player ID, which is arbitrarily set at the start of the match. If you got player ID 1, you are the dominant player. You must have logging turned on to see this. Note that before patch 2.7, the challenging player in a friendly match was always player ID 1, but this is no longer the case. In this example, Nightcave is the player going first, but I am the dominant player, as we can see from the tags. Now, we've reached the lightning quiz part of the video. Play Shadow Madness, Power Overwhelming on what you stole, then end your turn. What happens? I guarantee you will not see the outcome coming. Seems normal enough, right? Now watch what happens when Nightcave does the same thing. As you can see, the outcome was dependent on who played Shadow Madness and Power Overwhelming. The reason is because of the dominant player bug. Now we introduce the split queue. When I said each event had one associated queue, that was a simplification. There are actually two associated queues, one for the dominant player, then one for the secondary player. They are populated separately, the second after the first is resolved. In that video, Padishu was the dominant player and Nightkev was the secondary player. When Padishu did the test, Shadow Madness and Power Overwhelming queued in the dominant player's queue on the end of turn phase. Shadow Madness triggered first, and Power Overwhelming became ineligible to trigger due to the change of owner. Next, the secondary player's queue is populated, triggering Power Overwhelming right away. When Nightkev did the test, the dominant player's queue was empty, then Shadow Madness and Power Overwhelming queued in the secondary player's queue. Once again, Power Overwhelming became ineligible to trigger, and this time there is no later queue to join. Let's watch the footage again, armed with your new information. In addition, pay attention to the second Power Overwhelming Padishu casts. In particular, it triggers before the first Power Overwhelming. This is further proof of the split queue. It remains in the dominant player's queue, triggering before the first Power Overwhelming that was shoved to the second player's queue. Don't forget that Power Overwhelming triggers at the end of any turn. It is the disruption of changing owners before it can trigger that allows it to fail to trigger. Padishu is the dominant player in this example too. Let's observe the split queue again by destroying a Deathlord and putting the player Flesh-Eating Ghoul. If the secondary player owns the Deathlord, the dominant player's queue has already been resolved, so the Flesh-Eating Ghoul does not trigger off of the death. However, if the dominant player owns the Deathlord, by the time we reach the secondary player's queue, the Flesh-Eating Ghoul is eligible, queued, and resolved. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, and have not seen it yet, I suggest you watch our previous video, When Do Minions Die? It's 20 minutes long and will give you the comprehensive mental model of how advanced mechanics work in Hearthstone.